again to remember before God Her late Majesty Queen Elizabeth II, to give thanks for her life, to comfort one another within our grief, and to renew our trust and confidence in Christ, and to pray together that we may be one in Him, through whom we offer our prayers and praises to the Father. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
We open with a prayer. Almighty God, you judge us with infinite mercy and justice, and love everything you have made. In your mercy, turn the darkness of death into the dawn of new life, and the sorrow of parting into the joy of heaven. Through our Saviour Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We now have some words and prayers of confession, followed by receiving God's forgiveness. God has shone in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of His glory in the face of Christ. But we have this treasure in earthen vessels to show that the transcendent power belongs to God and not to us. As we acknowledge our human frailty, we call to mind our sins of word, deed, and omission. And we confess them before God our Father.
Amen.
You raise the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You bring pardon and peace to the broken in heart. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You make one by your Spirit the torn and divided. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May God our Father forgive you your sins and bring you to the eternal joy of His kingdom, where dust and ashes have no dominion.
Amen.
Merciful Father and Lord of all life, we praise you that we are made in your image and reflect your truth and light. We thank you for the life of our late Sovereign Lady Queen Elizabeth, for the love she received from you and showed among us. Above all, we rejoice at your gracious promise to all your servants, living and departed, that we shall rise again at the coming of Christ. And we ask that in due time we may share with your servant Elizabeth that clearer vision promised to us in the same Christ our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, world without end.
Amen.
And we sit for our Old Testament Bible reading.
Thanks be to God.
affection and the love. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this? She said to him, "Yes, Lord. I believe that you are the Messiah, the Son of God, the one coming into the world." This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Even a bit boring, but
showed there is joy in serving others. And she showed this so much that she inspired other people for generations. Yes, she took her role seriously and was certainly dedicated to it. Yet she also seemed delighted in serving us, taking pleasure in it even. She lived her whole life as one of loving, selfless service. And she did so with a smile on her face. And we know, most especially from her messages each Christmas to the nations, that this, her life of loving, selfless, joyful service, was motivated by her Christian faith. Now, I'm sure we've all recently heard the Prime Minister, Liz Truss, describe Queen Elizabeth as the rock on which modern Britain was built. And I do imagine this image resonates with many of us here today. The Queen has been our ruler for most of our lifetimes. She's gently and persistently governed us, and been a constant in our ever-changing lives in an ever-changing world. And the Queen has done so, governed and cared for us, being our rock with Jesus as her rock, as the foundation of her life. She carried out her duty, motivated by her faith, relying on God. It was her faith which underpinned her wonderful life of joyful service that she gave to us. She put God at the centre, relying on the one permanent rock. She imitated the way of Jesus in serving others with kindness, and as a consequence, she showed there is great joy in doing so. She did her best for us, carried out her responsibilities, faithfully serving her country day after day by taking her strength and comfort from God. So today, we give thanks for all of this and for so much more. For all that the late Queen Elizabeth II gave to us, our country, the Commonwealth, and the Church. For her life of joyful service and loving Christian witness. And as we do mourn her passing, we can help keep her memory alive by living as she lived. Doing small things with great love and joy. And each day, putting our trust in God. I think it's only right, though, to give the final words of today's sermon to the late Queen herself, who in her Christmas broadcast in 2002 said, "I know just how much I rely on my faith to guide me through the good times and the bad. Each day is a new beginning. I know that the only way to live my life is to try to do what is right, to take the long view, and to give of my best in all that the day brings, and to put my trust in God. Amen."
Let us pray. Eternal God, our Heavenly Father, we bless your holy name for all that you have given us in and through the life of your servant, Queen Elizabeth. We give you thanks for her love of family and her gift of friendship, for her devotion to this nation and the nations of the Commonwealth, for her grace, dignity, and courtesy, and for her generosity and love of life. We praise you for the courage that she showed in testing times, the depth of her Christian faith, and the witness she bore to it in word and deed. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Eternal God, we pray for our sovereign Lord, the King, and all the royal family, that you might reassure them of your continuing love and lift them from the depths of grief into the peace and light of your presence. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
Eternal God, be close to all of us who mourn, that we may find comfort and hope in your love. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Eternal God, we pray for our new King, Charles III. Bless his reign and the life of our nation. Help us to work together so that truth and justice, harmony and fairness flourish among us. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
God of mercy, entrusting these into your hands, all that you have made, and rejoice in our communion with all your faithful people, we make our prayers through Jesus Christ, our Saviour.
Amen.
Stand for our prayers of commendation. Into your hands, O Father and Lord, we commend your servant, our late Sovereign Lady Queen Elizabeth. Enlighten her with your holy grace, and suffer her never to be separated from you, O Lord in Trinity, God everlasting. May God, in his mercy, grant us, with all the faithful departed, granted. Rest and peace.
Amen.
We continue our service with the peace. Jesus says, peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. Not as the world gives, do I give it to you. Do not let your hearts be troubled, neither let them be afraid. May the peace of the risen Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
And we share with one another a symbol of that peace.
Thank you.
and praise, Holy Father, Heavenly King, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. And now we give you thanks, because through him you have given us the hope of a glorious resurrection, so that, although death comes to us all, yet we rejoice in the promise of eternal life. For to your faithful people, life is changed, not taken away. And when our mortal flesh is laid aside, an everlasting dwelling place is made ready for us in heaven. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and singing.
Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ,
in the unity of the Holy Spirit. All honour and glory are yours, O Holy Father, for ever and ever.
Amen.
As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven,
hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
We break this bread to share in the body of Christ.
Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread.
Receive the blessing and the love of God. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be upon you today, Lucy and always. Amen. body and blood of Christ. Receive the blessing and the love of God, the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you today and always. Receive the blessing and the love of God, the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you today.
the new and eternal Jerusalem. Grant to us, in the days of our pilgrimage, that fed with the living bread of heaven and united in the body of your Son, we may be the temple of your presence, the place of your glory on earth, and a sign of your peace in the world. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Oh, Thank you.